bitch out. On YouTube, today's video I'm going to be showing you the best low level setup for the C58 assault rifle in season 4. You unlock this gun at tier 31 or tier 30, so you're gonna have to do a little bit of grinding before you actually are able to use the gun, or you could purchase the tiers. I did not. I just played the game until I unlocked it because I didn't feel like wasting money on this. So if we go to the class setup, you can see that I'm rocking the Milstop reflex. Now, I do recommend using a sight for this gun because the recoil is not the best, I will admit. It's more of like an Odin from Modern Warfare 2019, if that makes sense. It has good power and good damage, but the recoil is just not there. So if we go to the muzzle, you can see that I'm rocking the muzzle brake 7.62. This just gives +4% vertical recoil control, which again is good for this gun because it needs recoil control, because the recoil on this gun is just not the best. Then if we go to the barrel, you can see I'm rocking the 15.6 ultralight. This is the first barrel you unlock. None of these are very useful. I mean, this is useful, but it takes a little bit of leveling up to do. So if you're just now unlocking this gun and you want like a starter class, this is what I would use, because the 5% strafe speed and the +10 aim walking movement speed is just, it's very good for this gun because it means you can move side to side fairly quick. And the thing with this gun is you always want to have your sights up. You always want to be aimed down sight because you don't want to be in close range engagements with this gun. It's more of a long range, hold down a lane, hold down one angle type of gun. You're not going to be moving a whole lot with this gun, so just being able to move while you're aimed down sight at least helps a lot. It means you can strafe and kind of juke out the enemies. And then for the body, I choose the steady aim laser. This is also the first attachment you unlock for this category. In case somebody does run up on you, it's nice to have the +20% hip fire accuracy. Again, it's not ideal close range, but this does help give you more of a chance if you are in a close range engagement. We go to the underbarrel, you see I'm using the foregrip, +12 horizontal recoil control, no cons. Awesome attachment for a starting attachment and for this gun, which honestly, I don't really like either one of these. I never ever use any of these attachments for any of my guns, so foregrip works perfect. If we go to the magazine, 35 round drum, this is honestly a must because this gun only has 20 bullets. So giving that extra 15 bullets allows you to get more feeds and just allows you to have more ammo, because 20 bullets is not a lot at all. And even though the fire rate is slow, you still go through even 35 rounds pretty quick. So 35 round drum mag is a must for this gun, I will say. And for the handle, I choose the drop shot wrap, mainly because of the flinch resistance. Again, this gun is not very accurate when it comes to recoil. So when you're getting shot at, obviously the recoil is going to get worse. So having the flinch resistant is very useful for this gun. You could run the speed tape if you want. It's always a great option to be able to aim down sight faster, but if you level the gun up a little bit more, I can't remember what level you have to be to unlock the drop shot wrap, but I would recommend using this if possible. If not, just use the speed tape. And then last but not least, the stock, I use the Marathon stock. Again, If you don't have it unlocked, use the tactical stock, aim walking, movement speed. It's useful, but the sprint to fire time is just way better in my opinion. So if you have the time and are willing to grind a little bit extra, I would recommend trying to grind for the marathon stock, because the sprint to fire time again helps this gun a lot, because you want to have your gun up at all times. So being able to bring it up faster is very useful. And that is the class setup, guys. If you did enjoy, please leave a thumbs up, consider subscribing, comment, all that good stuff, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace out.